Hey YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator course called Illustrator Essentials. You can check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. If you want to follow along with this video, there's exercise files, okay? Those are free to download. You can go and download those and there'll be a link in the description, okay? So you can play along. One last thing is there's a cheat sheet as well. So there is a PDF you can download from bringyourownlaptop.com. Look for resources, okay? It's a free PDF. You can download it, print it up, stick it next to the computer while you're doing these videos. All right, enjoy the video. Bye now. Hey there, it's cheat sheet time and only the best shortcuts. Let's go through them now. First one is actually two shortcuts. If I hit Command Y on a Mac or Control Y on a PC, it goes me into kind of like invisible X-ray mode. Okay, and I can see there's a star there and a dot there and a dot there. If I turn it back off by hitting the same key, you can see they just shapes that have, that's a text box that has no type. That is our anchor point from my pen tool. And over here is a star with no stroke and no fill. To tidy it up, go up to Object, go to Path, and go, let's just clean up all that stuff, please, Illustrator. Click OK. Now if I go back to my Command Y or Control Y on a PC, all tidied up. Nice. The next cheat is that, let's say these stars here, I want to change the color, but that color's being used a few times through my document. So what I can do is I can go up to here and say Select Illustrator, grab everything that's using that same fill color. Super handy. I can go to my properties, go to my fill color, and I'm going to say you're all white now. Awesome. Okay, the next one is math in any of the fields in Illustrator. Okay, I want to draw a rectangle. Actually, I want five little rectangles kind of evenly spaced down the bottom here. So I'm going to draw one that covers the whole thing. I'm going to give it a fill so you can see it. So I needed to divide it by five. Up here, the width, I'm even in the wrong unit size. I'm using points. Okay, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to put in /5. You could put in x5. You could put in -5. Okay, if I click on that, now it's 1/5 the size. Awesome. So I'm going to grab my black arrow, drag it across, and I want to duplicate these along. I could use copy paste, ends up in the middle. What I'm going to use is a trick where if I select it with my black arrow, I start dragging, and then after that, I hold down the Option key on a Mac or the Alt key on a PC. Makes a duplicate while I'm dragging. Okay, that's a handy little tip. Another little handy tip is if you now hit Command D on a Mac or Control D on a PC, it's gonna duplicate whatever you just did over and over again. Another handy trick. Next trick is, let's say I wanna grab this, I wanna give it, use my library colors, and I wanna give it the foxy orange color. But it didn't apply. Well, it did kind of, it applied it to the stroke. So the stroke was at the front. I needed this to be at the front. Click on that, and then I'll bring the stroke to the front and then click none. Okay, that's the long way. The shortcut way is this. I'm gonna undo till it was back to when it was broken. Okay, is that, watch this, the X key on your keyboard, can you see it over here? It just toggles these back to front. So up here I can say I want you to have the foxy center, and then I'll have maybe a black stroke on the outside. Okay, so you can toggle these back and forth. Even better is I want the stroke gone, so I'm gonna toggle it to the front and then hit my /// key. So it's the question mark on my keyboard, they're mixed up together down by the shift in the bottom right. So okay, click on this guy and I could say actually toggle the fill to the front and I want no fill with the /². If you wanna add a fill, you hit the comma button. That just adds a fill, pops this little box open as well. Okay, so if something doesn't have a fill, you hit the comma. The last one, and the one that nobody's gonna use, is the period or full stop. It adds a gradient. Well, you're not gonna use it. Gradients are back, right? Fill. So they're all kind of gathered down there at the bottom. Comma for a fill, period or a full stop for a gradient, and the /// for nothing in it. Back to gradients. I said gradients aren't gonna be used, but gradients are totally back. Check out this site. Gradient.com. I love it. It's just cool gradients that you can use. You can find a color, click on this, and that's the hexadecimal number to start with, and there it is to finish. They got pages and pages of very cool gradients. Let's put them in Illustrator. Okay, so I've copied the color from gradient. I've added the first one already to speed things up, and I'm going to click this last slider. It defaults to K often. Okay, we're going to go to RGB, and that's where this color needs to be pasted. I'm going to hit return. There's my lovely gradient. One more little thing about gradients, sometimes they can print badly with banding. If you go to File Print, there's an option to convert it into pixels, which is handy. Under Graphics, you can turn this on. This is, hey, don't do this unless you're having problems with gradients. If you are, hit Print, you'll find that they're pixels and they look nice. File size is a lot bigger, but that's okay. We want our gradient. Hit Cancel. Another cheat for Illustrator is, let's say I want to export this fox, just him by himself. Sending the whole document is easy enough. So actually, I'm going to drag a box around him, hold shift, click the background. I just want you, Fox, to go around. Okay, just with it selected, doesn't even have to be grouped. I can right click it, and there's an option that says export for selection. And there you are. Okay, just him's gonna get exported. He could be a PNG, he can be a PDF or a SVG, whichever you like. Awesome, let's hit cancel. Let's say you do want the whole thing as a PDF, but your PDF's coming out huge. Let's go to file, save. And in here, I'm gonna down the bottom, pick PDF, and I'm gonna click save. And even if I change these to say the highest quality print, which a lot of people use, it's still gonna make a really big PDF. The trick is this button here, preserve Illustrator capabilities. Okay, you just need to turn it off. It's gonna save. Illustrator's not gonna like it, but it just means that it's not going to have all the functionality of Illustrator, which we don't need it to have. That's what the AI file's for. Okay, the PDF just needs to be small and printable. One other thing you might do is down here, there's an option that says smallest file size. That turns it off by default, lowers the resolution a bit, and will make it even smaller, but probably not right for print, but definitely right for emailable or downloadable from our website. Let's hit cancel. Next up are some more shortcuts. Okay, Command Shift P is to bring in a file to import. It's not a particularly sexy shortcut, but I use it quite a lot. I'm gonna bring in this file here. I'm gonna click, hold and drag it so it's nice and big in the background. I need to send it to the back, so next shortcut time. If you're on a Mac, it's Command Shift, and you're looking for these square brackets. They're next to your P key. You want the first one. If you're on a PC, it's Control Shift, and hit that same square bracket. Sends it to the back. Now I'm gonna select both of them and use another shortcut. Okay, Command 7 on a Mac or Control 7 on a PC. It's the clipping mask. Next, and reasonably related, is that one's the clipping mask. That's for cropping things. The other one is cutting holes in things. So I've zoomed in here. I'm gonna click him, hold shift, click that tail. Next to Command 7 is Command 8. Okay, and it is compound path. There's now a hole in it. If you're on a PC, it's Control 8. Zoom back out. Next shortcuts I use loads are for fonts. So I'm gonna have my text selected up here. Command shift on a Mac or Control shift on a PC and tap the period key. Increase the font size, the comma key goes back smaller. So I get the font size kind of where I want it, about there. Next thing I wanna do is I wanna decrease the leading or the space between the lines. Okay, I've all got it selected. Hold down the option key on a Mac or alt key on a PC and just hit the up arrow on your keyboard. Okay, that decreases it and the down arrow increases it. Another thing you might do is with that same key held down, alt or option, use the left and right arrows to do the tracking. That's what I want. A couple more shortcuts to go with my black arrow. Say I wanna move this around, I can use my arrow keys, right? Just on my keyboard. But if I hold down shift while I'm using my arrow keys, it times it by 10, okay? So instead of moving just one pixel, it's gonna go 10. Nice and handy for that. Now you can use that for a lot of things. Let's say this thing, I wanna increase the font size properties, but I wanna go really big. Okay, so if I do it once, it's gonna go 18, 19. Okay, but if I hold shift and do it, it goes up 20, 30, 40. Okay, so it's just hold down shift and it will times anything by 10. It might be the stroke weight, okay? You can add a stroke to this font, it's gonna look bad, okay? And you can go up in 10 points by holding shift. Wow. Now two more to go. This is kind of a new feature. If you're not using CC 2018 or above, it might not work for you. You're working over here, right? But I've got my tail selected. I did it down there. So if I hit Command Plus, which a lot of people use to zoom in, it jumps down here and you're like, no, 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 over here. And then Command Plus again, it really wants to bring that into the middle. What you can do is you can go up to Illustrator CC Preferences. If you're on a PC, it's under Edit. Right down the bottom should be Preferences. Okay, and in here, we're gonna go to General, go to Selection and Anchor Display, and down here where it says Zoom to Selection, you can turn that off, and it will just zoom into the middle of the screen like the good old days. One other thing people love in here, or don't like about the new version, is under General, you can say this one here, it says Show the Start Workspace. Okay, it opens up all your previous files, and if you're old school Illustrator, people don't like that. You can turn that off, and it just loads up with an empty software. I'm gonna turn mine back on, click OK. And the last one is a time saver. It's when you're working with a file like this. It's one of the files that we made in our exercises for compound shapes. And what we did is we added a gradient to it, which is no big deal, especially in something like Photoshop. But watch what happens when I try and scale this up. I'm gonna go, yep, scale, and my machine rolls over and dies. Now, I've got like a brand new MacBook Pro. It should be flying. Illustrator doesn't do things like effects very well. So if you're going mad with waiting for your computer to do things like this, wow, it's long. okay, is when that's finished, I can go up to effects, go to document raster settings, and this thing here is gonna save the day. You're gonna turn down and say, I want the resolution down to 72. It's not gonna destroy your resolution, nothing's disappearing, it's still vector, but it means when I work now, I can make it bigger, and it's just a whole lot quicker, you see. The one thing you need to remember though, is when you're exporting your PDF, you need to make sure you turn it back up, because it will remember 72. So while you're working, crank it right low. When you go out, when you pre-press process, make sure you ramp it right back up to 300. All right, that is going to be it. See you in the next video. Hi, what did you think of the video? If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also leave me a comment, let me know what you liked about it. Also, this is kind of a short part of a longer course, okay? If you wanna check that out, it's at bringyourownlaptop.com. This is the essentials course. Okay, there is also another course, there is an advanced course, okay, for Illustrator, and also a UI web app design version of Illustrator course as well. Check all those out. Also, it's quite a visual course. I'd love to see what you've actually made. On Instagram, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop. Okay, check that out. Also, remember there's a cheat sheet you can download. Bring Your Own Laptop. It's free under resources. Check all that out, and yeah, I'll see you in another video. Bye now.